H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
And this is the phone number they are providing. Carrier phone number also here. Now what you can is, you can use this phone for your testing purpose. So testing your Android application, testing your Android phone, testing your iPhone, it will not make a huge difference for the tester. Now this is my iPhone. Now I wanted to play with this iPhone. I wanted to test my application with this iPhone. So here also, whenever if you want to test your application with your iPhones, you will be getting .ipa file. I told you, iPhone's files where extension will be .ipa, iPhone archive. Once you get that .ipa file, you can install in your iPhones. But it is not like your Android. Android means you will get .apk files, n number of files, .apk files for your testing purpose. Because Android is a free, open source. So anyone can use it, anyone can play it. Not like your iPhone files. Because iPhone files are very secure and then you will not get any applications for your testing. In the real time only, you will be having your .apk files for your test. Okay, so you will not get any .apa files in the internet. If you Google it also, you will not get it. Now here we are having one IPA file for our testing purpose, but it may not install successfully, right? But I will show you how, what is the installation process and then how to do it. So this is my application. This is my iPhone. I want to install my application. Then what you can do is, you can go to install, click on next, browse for it. See, if you have your repository, earlier you remember, right, if you are storing that files in your repository, you can also get it from here directly if you want. Okay, now go to your local, click on browse, and my IPA files are available. I have one IPA file actually. I will show you IPA file, my IPA file. This is the IPA file. You can see that it's a IPA file, iOS app. It's a IPA file. Click on open. Okay, it's a IPA file, test app.ipa file. Click on next. But it may not install successfully because, as I said, iPhones, you cannot simply use that .ipa file and all. It should be registered with your Apple. See, it is saying that installation is successful. But if you go to your device, you can see it is saying that waiting. It will never install. It will always say that waiting only. Your application will never install. Because this IPA files is not having any signed. That means whenever if you are developing your Apple applications, you have to sign with your Apple credentials. Then only it will work. See? It will be like this one. It will never install. Now the process is, installation process is, whatever I showed, that is the process. Just click on your install, select your .apa file, and then install in your device. Once the application is installed, the process is absolutely same. Now here also, I will say, for example, this is my application. I install my application successfully in my iPhone device. Once the installation is over, then what I will do? I will be start testing my application with the available test cases. I have all the test cases. Take the test cases and then start executing your test cases. When you are executing your test cases, now the same story. Whenever if you are getting any issues, you can report the defects. While reporting the defects, you may need your screenshots or you may need your log files. The process is same. for the same device, if you want to see your logs or screenshots, you can see here. This is your screenshots. You can click on your screenshot. Then whatever the current screen is there, that will be captured here. The current screen will be captured here. Whatever the current screen is there, that will be captured here. Now the same thing, if you want to save to your repository or if you want to save to your local PC, absolutely fine, you can do that. Now if you want to take your log files, you can take your log files also. That means if you say that get logs, it will get you all the log files. It will get you all the log files. Then what you can is you can share these logs to your dev team. So development team can easily understand what is the issue all about by seeing the logs. If you're not giving the logs, even for developers also, it is very easy to identify the root cause of the defect, right? Even developers also, they should know in which scenario this application is failing. Based on that only, they can do, they can work. Okay, fine. Now here also, if you want, you can, what you can is you can also record your application for your future references. The process is same as usual. Okay, the process is absolutely same as usual. Now, so I mean, if you want to collect your statistics, device statistics, here is your device statistics. How much memory is available? What is the CPU usage? What is the network? The complete details will be available here. Okay, fine. So this is how you can play with your Android phones or iPhones. Now here you are having some options. You can see that some options. That means, like say for example, if you are doing your interruption testing for any application, you are working with that application and you are doing your interruption testing for your application. Whenever if you are doing your interruption testing for your application, so you can see that call me. That means, right, you are working with your application. You open your application, and then when you open your application, see, I'm getting a call. See, what is the scenario here is, I open my H2K Infosys application, I'm testing, I'm working with that application, and I want to check this interruption scenario. When I'm saying that interruption scenario, what I will do is, I'm working with that, then I want a call, I want to get a call from my friend. Then what these people are providing is, they are also providing the call me functionality. When you say that call me functionality, then automatically you will be getting a call from your vendor like this, whatever you got. Got it? So you are also having your interruption testing scenarios also you are having. Okay. Now, this is the same process like here also. If you go to the repository, and if you want to maintain your test cases, then what you can is you can maintain your test cases. Otherwise, it's better to maintain the test case in your Excel document because you guys are comfortable to maintain your test case in your Excel. That is absolutely fine. No problem with that. These are all the extra features available with your Perfecto. Basically, Perfecto is nothing but it's a cloud-based testing tool. They will provide all your devices in the cloud so that you can access any device, whichever the device you want, you can access it and you can use it for your testing. This is absolutely real device. Absolutely real device. Okay, clear. Okay, fine. So if you want, you can SMS and all, that's fine. Now one more thing is, let me tell you one more point here is, now say for example, now say for example here, okay, let me close this. Now say for example here, you are having your test execution next week, and then you are working with this tool and you are getting some devices from the tool for your testing purpose. That is, my testing is scheduled for next week. This kind of situation, what you can is, you can reserve your devices for your testing. That is also possible. That means, right, this is the device. this is the device I'm using, I'm planning to use next week for my testing. Then what you can do? You can reserve it. See, when I say that reserve, so that this cannot be used by someone else, because these are real devices. Only one device can be used by at a time by one person. Because real device, how multiple people can use at a time. It's a real device. It's not the software. It's a real device. Only one person can use it at a time. So what you can do is, I want to test my application next week. Then what you can do is, you can reserve these devices. Because if you are saying, say for example, if you are testing your latest mobiles like iPhone 9.2, iOS 9.2, this kind of voice, it's a very latest version. So it will be very demand. So everyone will use the same device for the testing purpose. So what you can do is, it's better to reserve for your period. Click on reserve. And this is the iPhone I'm trying to reserve. So when you want to reserve, you can give the start time, you can give the end time, and click on OK. So that your device will be reserved for you for that particular time. So you can also do your registration as well. So basically what I'm trying to do is, I'm trying to test my application, but I want this device for so and so particular time, particular period. So you can reserve it. That's absolutely fine. See, it's a free account. If you observe that this is a free account, that is the reason you can see maximum like 50 or 60 devices in this catalog. If you see here, maximum you can find 50 or even less. So because it's a trial account. So what they are doing is, they are giving you like 20 or 30 devices for your understanding purpose. And if you want to test your application with your real devices, any real device, whichever the model you want, then you should be a premium member with this tool. So these guys, what they will do is, they will be charging per device on hourly basis. Okay. And one more thing, say for example, if you are testing your application with your latest device, now Android 6.0 also came into picture. So I want to test my application with Android 6.0, and I don't have any real device with that 6.0. Then what you can do? You can come here, you can submit a request so that these people will provide you that real device in the cloud. Then what you can do is, you can start playing with this tool. This is all about your tool. Any doubts here? If you have any doubts, let me know. Yes, this is, yeah, like this, you are also having, I told you, right, you are having this concept, right, whoever is providing these devices in the cloud, you are having the perfecto. These are all the people who will provide this real devices in the cloud. Perfecto, device anywhere. See, device anywhere concept also almost same. Like this perfecto, only these people are providing you that devices in the cloud, and you can start testing your application. The same process, absolutely same process. If you understand one tool, working with any other tool will be the same, absolutely same procedure. And then CTest Cloud. These are the three vendors. These are the three vendors who is providing devices in the cloud. Okay, so there is no difference between Perfecto and Device Anywhere, Soma. I will tell you one thing. What is the difference between Gmail and Yahoo Mail? Is there any difference between Yahoo and Gmail? Both are, what they are doing is, they are serving for the webmail. Similarly, this Perfecto and Device Anywhere is absolutely same. Like what these people will use, Perfecto will provide that real devices in that cloud. Even Device Anywhere also, they will provide that real devices in the cloud. But the UI may differ, right? UI, you can see here, right? This UI, look and feel may differ between your Perfecto and Device Anywhere. But the concept, like you can access your device and you can work with the device, and you can install the application, you can take the logs, you can take the screenshots, and you can maintain your test cases, you can maintain your recording. All these features will not change between your Perfecto or device anywhere. Features is absolutely same. Maybe that look and feel may change. Yes, that's correct, Soma. So features will be absolutely same, but the provider is different, right? That's what, right? It's simple, straightforward. You want to do your testing with your real devices, and the real devices are in the cloud. Then these are the vendors, Perfecto, real device anywhere, and CTS cloud. And out of which, like Perfecto is little people are using this tool little more than your device anywhere or CTS cloud. Perfecto is little popular tool, I can say. Okay, and this is what your tool. Okay, with this tool, right, we are done with this Perfecto also. So now what I will do is, in the next session, I will be talking about your CTS automation, and followed by your resume preparation and interview questions. I will give you the link where you will find your interview questions also. Okay, that's it for today, guys. If you have any doubt, let me know, and do your practice. Yes, this is the link. Okay, let me give you the link one more time. No problem, I will give the link. This is the link. Just go here, and then just again, let me give the link one more time to everyone. So this is the link. Go to this link and register your account, but make sure that you are giving your email ID as a business email ID. It's not like Gmail or Hotmail, it will not allow you. Make sure that you are giving that business email ID, and if you're giving that business email ID also, nothing will happen, because it's just a trial account, and it's a 7 days trial account, and maximum you can use 2 hours or 1 hour, I guess. 1 or 2 hours maximum you can use it. And even though once you are done with your trial, it will be expired. You will not get any follow-up emails and all, right? It's nothing to worry. Just you can register here, and you can work over the weekend. And Monday we will be connecting to discuss that CTS automation too. Oh, okay, Soma. Okay, yeah. Okay, fine.